All right, we here. Nobody here as of yet. But that usually changes. Sometimes it doesn't. We're just gonna see if we can get lucky today. We're just gonna have to wait and see. Just gonna have to wait and see. And we have a person here. Hi, Seb. All right, that's one. It's probably good enough to start. If we got one, there's a good chance we got more coming. Series was made not too long ago, so I might not have that much to talk about with it. But I probably will have things to talk about with it nonetheless. Like, for instance, the top of that door frame, it bothers me. It's crooked. I don't know, I must have like OCD or something, but wow, that is. It's a bit blurry. Let's hope that fixes itself. I don't know, my Wi-Fi. How many bars do I have? I have three. Three bars is doing this crap. Jeez, man. A lot of people in the comments related this to the video game changed, which I can see. But, there's a lot more humans. Definitely not as many humans in changed. You know what? This video quality we got right now looks like it was recorded with a potato, so that's accurate. Hold on, I got some lemonade up here. I'm gonna drink that. Still hasn't fixed itself. Whatever, I guess we can kinda read it. Keyword kinda. Oh, there we go. Right, this isn't actually the first appearance of this dude. He was in a scrapped intro I did, but I couldn't format it correctly and get it onto my laptop. I probably could, but I couldn't get it onto my iPad. That was the thing. So I got rid of it, didn't use it. But it worked out because it wasn't accurate to how the series is going anyway. But it did have him in it. That's the only real positive. So what I did with the intros instead, as you can see, is I just took a random frame and then, I don't know, added a few, I don't know, just random Morse code because you're in a big tower, bunch of techie stuff going on. Yeah, that sounds about right. So this next scene, it's a bunch of old characters from the original Werewolf movie. As you can see, there's one, there's two. They never show up again, and then there's another one later in this episode. Never shows up again either. I felt like it just had to add them so people would be like, "Where the wouldn't be like, where the heck are they? They were in the original series. Where'd you put them?" I put them in the land of non-existence. That's where they are. I just realized this. How can they? They have to like sneak around the entire tower, looking past a bunch of guards and stuff, when they're actually trying to escape. How can they get to his office completely fine when they're just going to go steal a paper from it? They don't get questioned or anything. That's weird. I don't know. Maybe then. Yeah, plot hole. I don't know. If they're monsters and they're able to, like, transform and attack people, I don't really know if they need weapons. Oh, yeah, that's true. The FBI went on, they have a bunch of weapons. They only have weapons when they're actually right. Actually, wait. Yeah, they do have weapons, but they only feel the need to use them when they're, like, right by the door to escape. Which I guess makes sense. But I don't know, just. You know what? Never mind. Pass Dan, that makes sense. Good job. Good job with your plot writing, whatever's. Right, I forgot the first episode was just them looking for a map. They're not actually escaping yet. Here's the first shot you see of the outside. That is a red sky. That's the reddest sky I've ever seen. Actually, wait, no, that's not true. Is it? I'm questioning a lot of stuff today, as I can, as you guys can tell. I tend to do that a lot, but I don't know. I guess I'm like tired or something. Maybe. Possibly. They couldn't find a map. They couldn't just search the same place they found the paper in his office. Pretty sure there would be a map in there. Actually, wait, no, I think that is where they find it. Why didn't they just look in there in the first place? And there is a werewolf. What is this? Well, Dan, that looks to be a test tube. And there's the guy over there writing stuff down. Don't remember what he's writing down. It's probably something about, I don't know. Actually, wait, no, I don't remember. I remember, but they're gonna show it later on, so I might as well not tell. Plus, you guys watch this, you already know. Drinking the lemonade. Lemonade is great, by the way. Pink lemonade, regular lemonade, they're both great. This lasts for about like 10 seconds, I think. Maybe, yeah, 10. Not 15, not 20, definitely 10. I'm not counting though. Stupid. Yep. This wounded cannon. Probably not. I don't think. Maybe it's like an alternate universe or something, but I don't know. That wouldn't make sense because why is John there? You see, though, that's because in 2017 me had was in middle school, and in middle school they give you a lot less work. In high school they just pile it on like it's the like free food at a buffet. Oh, yeah, there it is. I didn't notice. So, you know what? That is a good reason to escape. You don't want to die. I would do that too, except I don't know how I would do it because I probably wouldn't be able to come on an escape plan. I probably wouldn't be able to team up with people. Yeah, I'd be dead. Oh, there's Mia in the back. She also doesn't ever appear again. But if you know, if you've watched this series, we do get a new character. Not next episode, but the episode after it. That's actually, his lines are written by a person I know on Discord. Probably not gonna like shout anything out about him because I don't want to leak any information, but actually his name should be in the credits of the first video he appears in. So maybe I can show that or something. I can probably show that at the end. Oh, speaking of which, I think we're about to move on to the second episode. Yep. Which would be, God, I've got weird recommendations. Actually, no, never mind. Yeah, second episode. Explore the floor. Trick on Deadly Depths. Okay. Uh-oh, he knows now. Dan, you gotta be more sneaky. Though, you know what? That's fair. He's a werewolf. He's probably leaving hairs all over the place. Can't have time to pick them all up. And on to episode two we go. Oh, it's dark yet again. All was quiet. Wait, no, it wasn't. Wait, no, it wasn't. Yep, I remembered. And now they're about to start some escaping. This is where the series really starts to pick up. Though episode one was actually pretty good, I think. Set up the good story, brought in the new character, had the werewolf. Maybe. That is a distinct possibility. I actually don't know how long each of these five episodes combined is, like, time-wise. So I guess we're gonna find that out. I mean, each episode is about 14 minutes. That's. I don't know, I don't feel like doing math. Boy, he about to jump. Oh, that poster on the right, that's drawn by another person I know on Discord. He also did the thumbnails for all the episodes. He's also in the credits. I can probably show him at the end as well. I mean, it did get them out of the way, so I guess it worked. Just a bit gruesome, but I guess that's fair for a werewolf. Oh, I actually really like this scene up here. It's spooky. It's all dark. Spooky stuff goes down. But it's also short, doesn't go on for too long. And there it is. Well, it sure is dark in here. Great observation, Dan. It sure is. So dark that you can't even see another person in there with you. Oh yeah, that blinking effect is really cool, actually. Oh, he's about to zoom on by in a sec. Dang, I just realized there's a lot of references from Discord servers I'm in this. Springy axled acceleration sticks. Everyone in a server I'm in referred to legs as that for a while. So if you're wondering where that came from, that's where. Oh, that's just the mustached guy who runs the tower that we saw earlier. There's Sonic, there's Tom from Ed's World. See, we got a lot of references in the series. Can't remember if there was any in the first episode, though. I don't think so. But there's also a lot in the third episode. There's one in the fourth episode. There's one in the fifth episode. I think there's just not one in the first episode. Actually, wait, no, there's two in the fourth episode. I'll point out all the references and stuff when they come by. About halfway through the second episode. Running out of flashback in the next scene. This flashback was originally supposed to be the first scene in the first episode, but I just turned it into a flashback because that scene would have taken a long time. Actually, no, I probably could have done the scene exactly like this and put it in the first episode, but I was originally gonna do it like full on pictures, not just the text over a black background. That would have taken a while. And you get an FBI open up and yep, right there. I remember that was in there, and that's one of the few things I remember from this episode. It's a lot of it's filler, to be honest. Except it does introduce the characters that's gonna be shown in the next episode after this a lot. We're almost 25 minutes in. We're doing pretty good. Actually, yeah, one of the reasons I do these live streams for every series I have is just to see how long they are, each episode stacked on top of each other. But also, it's fun to look back on and, I don't know, watch all the videos together and hear me commenting over them. Watching the live stream chat. It's fun. It's a fun time. Yep, this scene is the first appearance of the new character. But it's after all this text goes by, he just appears for like 1 or 2 seconds. Most likely. I don't even know where they got that. I think they probably got it in like a black market or something. But then again, I don't know why they'd have it. Maybe it was just like. Maybe it was left over in the fridge before they bought the house. I don't know. Oh, there it is. There's the only shot we see of the whole tower. Not really the whole tower, mostly just the top. Never really see the base. I think this is the second to last scene. A lot of these episodes, the last scene always involves a villain. I don't know. That's a good question. I mean, he clearly knows some of the w a lot of the ways around a tower if he has a hidden exit in his floor that he can just open up all the time. Nobody suspects anything. So, I don't know. Yeah, probably he does know the way around the tower. No, you're good. If I do have any other, if I do have anything after, like, in the series again, like that was supposed to be the finale, but maybe I can like have like spin-offs or something. Maybe I can, maybe I can continue. I'm probably gonna have him return because he saw there were only like three, I think. Yeah, three characters in the final scene of the entire series. And on to the third episode we go. Another floor, another migraine. I think. I couldn't. I couldn't see it being on the text, but whatever, it was probably there. I think that was it and what it was. Morse code. And they're right outside the Neko's room, I think. Next floor. I mean, it doesn't really say, it just says through here. It doesn't really say the room's right there. I don't know. Just making things up as I go. I tend to do that a lot. My entire, the first video I ever made, the first, like, the original episode of the original werewolf movie was all improv. Wasn't until the second episode that I started actually trying to come up with a good plot. But hey, that shows that at least I know how to improvise. Oh yeah, I forgot. The scene has a little bit of a jump scare with the door closing noise. It only scares you if you expect it, or at least that's what it does to me, but I added it in there and I still sometimes forget. Also, it's really loud. Oh, dang, you can't even see the pentagram. You can see all the lines on the wall, scratch marks. And there it is. New character. Him. He was voiced by a friend I know on Discord. Or her. Yeah, it's her. Whatever, he, him, her, how, when, whatever. I don't know. There's all these people on Twitter, just cancel culture. My God. Like, I'm all for trying to, like, point out when something is terrible and not good and it's just be. It's just bad. But you don't need to straight up get rid of it or, like, ruin their life. That pentagram is a. That's the entrance to the tunnel. That's actually a pretty cool way to mark a tunnel, not gonna lie. Don't remember how I thought of that, but this tunnel animation coming up right here is actually really cool. That is nice. That's actually. Probably, there's only like a few, I think, I don't know, and that might be the only animation in this entire series. I don't know, maybe do the transitions for the title cards count? I don't know. Oh yeah, the blinking of the eyes in the second episode, that's kind of animation. Yeah, look at various references. We got Suction Cup Man. That was Henry Stickmin over there, but you can't really tell. Actually, I think this sound in the vents, it's not really music at all, but it's the first, like, kinda, maybe sorta soundtrack in the series. Comes in the third episode. And then fourth and fifth episodes where I actually start implementing it. Actually, now that I think about this, this same kind of soundtrack here is used in the final scene of the series. The volcano, that's a reference to the final part of the werewolf movie Outbreak, which I don't know, maybe it was kind of controversial, but it wasn't. Maybe it could have been better. There was a lot of typos and stuff. I thought it was all right personally. But if you guys noticed watching the series, there's not a single editing error in the entire thing. No typo, no missing frames, no text that goes by too fast. Oh dang, darn it, I should have moved the text out of the way. That's actually another animation. I forgot about that. I don't know, I might have to. Oh yeah, my old The Werewolf movie series has so many errors, like spelling errors. Basically everything I just mentioned about the series not having it has it. You can do that if you want. I don't mind. So, you may have noticed watching the series, there aren't really any like werewolf and TFs. The only thing that's come close are this vent scene. Maybe like the second episode, the first scene kind of implies one. There's a little bit of one in the fifth episode, but other than that, there's really not much. We had a full-on werewolf in the first episode and in the second episode, but other than that, yeah, not much. There's not a single werewolf scene in the fourth episode. Not that I can remember, at least. I was gonna add some originally, but I couldn't find a good way to implement them. Though I suppose there were ways, I don't know, maybe I didn't feel like it. But that's not a good excuse. That's definitely not a good excuse. Don't be like me. If you wanna do something, you actually gotta go and do it. Oh dang, we're already 40 minutes in. We're definitely gonna go past the 1 hour mark. Yep, that's a reference. Robert, he was definitely a main villain in the pre-story, and then he was a little bit of a villain in the last two parts, mostly the first and last, not the first, mostly the last part of Outbreak, and then all of pre-story. And then he's mentioned a little bit here. I don't remember if he had any ties to the villain of the original series. Dang, it's hard to refer to like the main like original series, the first three episodes, because the original The Werewolf Movie didn't have like a side title, because like there's the Werewolf Movie pre-story, there's the Werewolf Movie Outbreak, there's the Werewolf Movie 2, but the original is just the Werewolf Movie. Kinda. Yep, they're about to jump. This fourth episode is probably actually my favorite. It's got a good aesthetic. It's creepy. I don't know, I like a lot of creepy stuff. I've been watching a lot of horror movies lately. This, I don't know for sure, but it might actually be a reference to the second ever episode of the Werewolf Movie released when they go into the temple. Everything's all dark for a minute. All you can see is their eyes. Which is also a reference to episode of Ed's World. So it's a reference to a reference. Man, that's a lot of referencing. But that actually is a really good episode of Ed's World. You all should watch it. It's Ruined. I haven't seen that in a while. I should watch that. Oh, don't worry. You can take all the time you want. And we're about to transition into the fourth episode. No villain, they are most certainly not dead. You know what? Yeah, I'd think that too, but there was, I don't know, video, YouTube, some animation logic. He wouldn't know that they're alive at all if he wouldn't have gone to check the office first. They could have just escaped completely fine, no issues. Oh yeah, that's another kind of referencing the original like episode 2 of the original Werewolves movie. There's a part where Mia's in the car and she's trying to get everyone in, and she just straight up teleports everyone into the car. Okay, so two things to point out here. Person on the left, or no, right, that's another person I know from Discord. Person on the left. I don't know, man, I've been watching a lot of anime lately. I just wanted to throw a few characters. There's this one, and then there's one where it's just like a poster on the wall later. Point that out. Don't let them escape. That's some good formatting you got there, Dan. Totally. And title card. Think that's the last ever like traditional title card from the series. The next episode is just like the Star Wars kind of intro. Oh God, I forgot about this scene. There we go. There's some blood. Got some bones. Got some intestines. Just got an overall dead person. Okay, I haven't got a lot to say here. But you guys have probably come to expect that. I'm not the best at commentary. Commentary. Trying to think of things to talk about with that. Oh, that doesn't have anything to do with commentary, but you guys know I had. I mean, did you guys know I had, I think, yeah, just one YouTube channel before this one. I made this one back in 2017. I made my original YouTube channel 2014. Also, this is background music from Undertale. If you guys know where it's from, that's pretty cool. It's my original channel. It's cringy, so I deleted it, and none of that content exists anymore. You know what's surprising? I get a lot of comments, especially on my like Werewolf TF6 animation video that has like somehow like 14 million views. I get so many comments on that video saying, "Oh my god, I watched this video when I was a child, in childhood." I don't know how that happens. Didn't realize that video was that old. It's gonna be 5 years old next year. To meet a character that hasn't been seen for a very, very long time in the series. He was last seen in the second episode of Pre-Story, never seen again until now. And here you can see a little bit of a reference to like how much time has passed there. It's apparently 7 years, which I guess makes sense. I think that's the same as it was in Pre-Story. I want to keep continuity pretty good. I'm a little tired. Which is weird because I think it's only like, crap, what time is it? 4:02. I was gonna say 4, I was incredibly close. Sometimes I don't have a good sense of time, sometimes I do. And there you go, that's the only mention of werewolves in this entire episode. Actually, wait, no, that's not true. On his, like, scanner thing, the villains at the beginning of the episode, I think it mentions not their names, but their species. So there's only two. Oh, up here, that's one, this is one of my favorite jokes in the entire series. Dan, I'm a fucking ghost. This shit ain't easy. That's what I think about every time I think about like Ouija boards nowadays. It's not easy for the ghosts. Oh yeah, this is referencing Pre-Story as well because he saw his grave in, I think it was the third episode there. That third episode is actually also pretty dark. I'd say it's about as dark as this. Except maybe a little darker because there's something way dark in that episode that I don't know if I can do anymore on this entire channel. If you guys know what I'm talking about, then good. Yes, I am still active, hello. I don't have a lot of videos I can really post anymore. I mean, I probably can. It's just, there was a long point in my channel where I just post whatever I could think of and people would always get really mad, so I just don't really post a lot of that anymore, so there's not as much content on my channel anymore. Maybe I can get back into doing that. I don't have as much trouble with people yelling at me with what to do. So I can probably do that. Anyways, hi. Arm. Bloody arm. Up here. This is the second reference in the episode. That's another random character from the anime. That's really random. Figured that would be an issue. Is it like it's really loud so it's harder to hear me talking? Whatever, it doesn't matter. It's nothing important. Nothing important. Get the gist of it watching the series itself. Oh, dang, we're getting a lot of people. That's two people in the live stream. Just now, when there have only been two people in the live stream previously. But yes, hello. Don't worry, I've got a long way to go before I die. I'm gonna be only 18 this December. Got a long way to go. I wouldn't expect I'd die until maybe like late 80s, somewhere in the 90s. Except maybe if I got like some like freak accident or something. I hope that wouldn't happen. But then maybe you'd find out on the news or something. Actually, that elevator scene looks very, very similar to the scene in the first episode where they're about to go see everyone from the original series. Yeah, that would probably work. And we're about to transition into the fifth episode after this text goes by. Now, this fifth episode, it's a little the the video qualities are a little shitty. If you guys can't tell what the text says, or if it's kind of hard to tell, I'll make sure to I'll make sure to say what it actually says. Just so you guys know, in case you didn't know before. Oh dang, Star Wars title cards. Yeah, I always do the same with Freedom Gear Room. Episode 5, Imminent Escape. A sense of dread looms above. Nearing the end of a lengthy escape plan, Dan and his companions, Harold, John, and the Necco think they may finally be in the clear. No, they aren't. The mysterious man in charge, that's right, I never gave him the name, is against something of such a high caliber, and to put a stop to it, sends himself and every guard in the tower to form a blockade in the lobby to prevent the four rebels from leaving. Yep, that's the first scene. Meanwhile, the friends make their way to the first floor, completely unaware of the danger that awaits them there. Oh no! That's all I can say, just oh no. Previously, I'm just gonna go over another scene here. There's a thing I can do on this phone, watch this. Now the formatting doesn't look weird. Thank you, YouTube app. You are useful. Yeah, you can tell the quality's a little worse. That's only because this editor I used, since the Star Wars like intro is in a different format, the actual video format that the video is usually in got kinda blurry. I know it's kinda hard to explain, but you guys can obviously tell. Oh dang, I forgot I have this lemonade here. I'm thirsty. I'm thirsty as hell, and I want a drink, and I just forgot I had this here. Hold on. This music is from Super Mario RPG Legend of the Seven Stars. That's a game on the SNES, definitely a lot older than Undertale, so wouldn't be surprised if some people here don't know it. Oh dang, we got five. That's five people that have been in this live stream. That's a lot, if you guys don't know. I've got a lot of subs, but a lot of them are only subscribed because of that one video that has 14 million views. Which sucks, but I can't do anything about it. Except I guess make more content. That's usually a good way to get subs. Oh yeah, this is actually a cool scene with the button up at the top, and they have to use the gun to shoot it and then get the door open. Yeah, I can do that right now. Shout out to Dark Bonnie 87 fan, Duper Kirby Studios. Go to his channel, find out whatever the heck he's doing over there. Probably good stuff. Oh, hold on. Let me hide this for a sec. Let's see. There's my boy John back there. How you doing? There's also Harold back there, but he's blocked by Dan. Oh yeah, boss, I accidentally cut myself on something. Let it bleed will seem more intimidating. Great boss we got here. Yeah, there's only, I think there's only, like, there's at least two people. There's not a lot of people with guns there. That explains why, how they're able to get through, because if they all had guns, then they'd all be dead. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. Three to four, I don't know, four people cannot get through an entire mob of people all with guns. Oh, dang, okay, my favorite transformation, there's one in the original first video ever, of the original Werewolves movie, where he's jumping through the air and he transforms while he's in the air, and then by the time he gets down, he's a full-on werewolf. That's pretty cool. It's probably my favorite. I can't remember all of them, but that's one of the better ones. This is actually a really cool looking scene with the ground and the bridge and the moon in the background. That's good job, Dan. Oh, wait, did you want me to go through all of them? Dang. I mean, the thing with that is there's only like, I think there's only one TF in Pre-Story, only one TF in Outbreak, and there's zero TFs in number two, so it's mostly just stuff going off in the first series. Hold on, I got a crumb or something on my screen. I'm gonna move that real quick. There we go. I thought it would mess with something with the screen, but it didn't, so we're good. Oh yeah, this entire scene is actually a reference to a scene in an Indiana Jones movie. It's the second one. It's not, definitely not the favorite of all the Indiana Jones movie. That would be, I think, the third one. First would be the second favorite. Fourth is god awful. Nobody likes it. Second is all right. Just, I guess not that many people like it. It's really dark. Oh crap, I forgot to say what it is when it's really blurry. Whatever, I put it in the comments, you guys can see that. And the bridge is about to go down. There it goes, and there's a bunch of people dying. Oh, speaking of a bunch of people dying, watch this. Actually, hold on. Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of the chat for a second so you guys can see this in all its glory. And bye, Harold. Oh dang, yeah, we are over an hour. We're an hour and 8 minutes. This is a long series. But it's good. Good and long. If something is long, I don't care how long it is. If it's good, then it's great. Unless it's like absurdly long. Like, I watched the Titanic last week, that's 3 hours long, which is about as long as I can go with a movie. I think one of the Avatar movies is like 6 hours long. That's the, oh no. Oh yeah, the scene right here. This is the first implementation of anything green screen-like. I'll tell you a little bit about this. So it's a blood effect where the blood is going spraying from his head because he's dead. But I couldn't get it to look right with all the green gone from the actual green screen. So what I did was I don't know, I just pretended the green was like vomit and also blood. So it's a mix of the two. It's lazy, but it's lazy that works. When you can get away with something, then I don't know, yeah, you can get away with something. I don't know. You guys are gonna see that in a sec anyway. Oh yeah, we're coming up to the end of the series, by the way. We've only got a few more minutes. That's a good question. Oh, dang, did I already miss it? Hold on. Yeah, I'll go back and show that. Wait. That. The green and red. Not Christmas yet, you're right. I missed that. I now know what you're talking about. That's a good catch. Here's what I was talking about earlier with the same audio that was in the vent scene in the third episode. Right. And that is the end of the series. All right. Well, you're lucky there. It's 5 a.m. apparently. This stream is over. All right. That is all of the Werewolves movie 2. I hope you guys enjoyed. All right, like I said, I'm gonna show the credits real quick. There's me. There's the two people that compose the soundtracks for the video game soundtracks that I had in the video. There's the guy who did the lines for the Neko character. And there's Funny Dusto, thumbnail creator. 0121 R121 and Funny Dusto, you guys can check those out. They both have YouTube channels. I think one of them only has one video, but the other one has a bunch of videos. Anyways,